Company, and it's early in the morning and it's live, so you know it's another preview day, but this time it's for our October 6th, 7th, and 8th sporting and collector firearms auction. I'm here with Arthur. He's got a lot of iron in his diet, you might say, but just one of the thousands of items set up in our preview hall just waiting for you, because preview day, as you all know if you've seen these videos before, is open to the public. We open at 10 a.m. and you can come and inspect, you can come touch, you can come pick up, hold, and look at any of the items in the October 6th, 7th, and 8th Sporting Collector Firearms Auction. Notice that's Wednesday through Friday, a little different dates than we typically have, but it's feedback we get, it's what people like, so here we are. But enough from me. By the way, since we are open to the public, but if you can't come, you can, of course, as always, check out all the listings on rockislandauction.com. So enough from me. Let's flip this camera around and take a good look at some of the items in the sale. Walking right in the old front door. Oh, whoa. There's Piats. There's 1919 A4s. That one's a semi-auto version, but tripods if you need them. And of course, as always, you're usually greeted by beautiful Colter Winchesters. Very nice looking Henry, but my favorite in this little display, there's two, actually. One is a special order Winchester 76. To see these in person, boy, they're so different from the 73s. They're just so big, so fat, so impressive, and rightly so. They were gonna handle, you know, the more powerful cartridges that the 73 wasn't quite ready for. This is deluxe. You can see that beautiful case hardening still on there. Loading gate looks darn good. Checkered wood, fancy stock, semi-pistol grip. That's a beautiful gun, and loads of finish. Very nice. That's exactly what we like to see. And over in the corner, just around that, is a rare U.S. Springfield. It's a vertical Lee. Now, they call it, it's technically a Springfield, like model 1875. They call it the vertical Lee Springfield model 1875 to differentiate it from the other Springfield that were being produced in 1875. You notice this big, long hammer spur on the back. You notice it's sort of got this martini-looking action. That is correct. These were very, very low production numbers. Tested, never really quite adopted. You can find more info on our site. That is lot number 493, of course. And it's, of course, a rare U.S. Marshall long arm, so you know it's one of the items from the George Mahler collection. In case you missed our video earlier, which is about 400 reasons you need to come to this auction, there are over 400 lots in this auction filled with the items of George Mahler. Now, that's more than our September auction, more than our September premiere is in a sporting and collector auction. Now, the Mahler items that were in the premier auction in September, people were very excited for, because it's things like a Remington, like a vertical Lee. Like, where do you find these things? Where do you find like a Type 2A? Where do you find a type, like all these small little variations that people need to fill holes in their collections? Well, the Mahler collection, it was comprehensive. It had all these hole fillers. And so people were ready in September. There was an excitement. There was an urgency for people to try to complete their own collections, and rightly so. So take that excitement and move it into October, the 6th, 7th, and 8th Sporting Collector Auction. And it is more items than September had from the Mahler collection. So pretty excited to be able to offer that level of quality in a sporting and collector auction. Just take a look at some of these. Like the multi-barrel, like revolving rifles, fusils from the Middle East, sharps. Here we go, Colt revolving rifles. Just, you know, sitting on the rack. You can pick these up. You can touch them. You can come inspect them and learn and find out how they're different. In fact, what I was looking for, I know for a fact there's a Colt Patterson revolving rifle over here, and I was hoping to eyeball it and just show you, because how often you get to see a Colt Patterson, let alone one that's just sitting on a rack for you to be able to pick up and touch and inspect. As you can see, a lot of classic military surplus here. I'm walking past Mosins, I'm walking past Enfields, I'm walking past French guns, I'm walking past Martini Henrys. I'm walking past carbines. I'm walking past M1 Garands. You name it. No shortage of Mausers either. And on my left side was just a great number of Civil War pieces. Then into some double barrel sporting arms. And into some late 19th century arms as well. So let's get to some of these display cases. Oh, first of all, if you haven't been here before, if you haven't seen one of these, everything that we're looking at right now is going to be sold on the first day. That's going to be Wednesday. That much. Everything from this wall, about over, so about here, the 90 degree point, another 90 degrees, that'll be sold on day two. That'll be Thursday. And then our last day of auction, yeah, everything from about here and over, that'll be sold on Friday. Now, you heard about 400 items from the Mahler collection. What you haven't heard yet is there is 7,000 guns in the sale. That's 7,000 guns, not 7,000 lots. That 7,000 doesn't include, you know, the bronze art pieces. That doesn't include lots filled with bayonets. That doesn't include artwork. That doesn't include the suits of armor or these giant display pieces. That's 7,000 guns. I don't know about you, but I love gun shows, but any gun shows I go to anymore, they definitely don't have 7,000 guns. They got guys selling stun guns, cracking them off every minute, and some toys and some magazines and things like that. And you'll find a lot of guns. Well, here's 7,000 guns. It's the best gun show you've never been to. So this is open to the public. Please come see it. We promise it will be worth your while. You will thank us. Your pocketbook will not. Bayonets, handgun cases. And it's from all different eras. You can see we got Maynard tape primer, percussion pieces. We got Remingtons, Colts, flintlocks, percussion pistols of various makes, manufacturers from various countries. Various forms of flintlock and snap haunts and you name it. Adam's early double actions here we're getting to. We're getting into some pin fires. I know it's really hard to see with the glass. I generally tend to not come over, but I want to give you an idea of just how full these things are and how far they go. That's a lot of guns. Let's take a look at day two. Let's take a look at some of those items. In this display right here, we have some of the heavy hitters. There's another beautiful deluxe 76. This one, of course, in the big old 50 Express. Everybody likes to take one in 50 Express. Still got checkered deluxe wood. Very nice. It's a short rifle, so it's rare. And of course, we got a button mag on it, so it's also full of custom features besides just the wood and the checkering. Very cool. Right next to it, a Winchester 66 flat side. Of course, we have a flat gate right here, and you have the flat side where it comes flush into the stock. There's no scalloping there. That one offered at a little better price point, as you can see. Here's a beautiful monogram grade LC Smith. See if we can get the focus on there. And twist. How that's actually been relief cut out of there. Absolutely beautiful. A little touch of gold on top. Not too much. Some really creative and kind of beautiful fences. Very nice. And you can still see some of that vibrant case hardening on there. First model 73 that's been engraved. I mean, this is why you come. What other gun shows are you going to see these at? Now, there are the big collector shows kind of all over the United States. I'm more referring to your local show. So y'all get here, and I promise it's going to be more on par with the national, like, collector-grade gun shows that you're going to find. But it's bigger, and it's got more variety, and it's got, I mean, what else? What else do you want? So here's kind of one of my favorites from the sale, also from the Mahler collection. It looks like a 1903, but it's kind of not a 1903. It says right there, 1901 30-03 to Townsend Wheeler. It says 1901 because this is a model 1901. This is an experimental Springfield model 1901, still chambered in 30-03. 30-06 has not come into the picture yet. There's some Krag parts, there's some... They're putting things together. They're figuring it out. They're figuring out the 1903 at this point and how they want it to look and how they want it to function. You can see a lot of that Mauser action, though, is already in place. And where else are you gonna see one? This is one of two that are actually in the auction, of course, both from that Mahler collection. And right next to it, looks like a M1 Garand, except for down here, and you can see it's a gas trap M1 Garand, thus making it quite a bit more rare and quite a bit more valuable. So once upon a time, the Army did not want to drill through their barrels. So the barrel actually ends kind of back here. And this is actually a gas trap. It cups and takes the gas. This is just sort of a false muzzle, and it redirects the gas back that way. So it's sort of a cup, almost think like the bang system in a way, but it's taking that gas and using that to redirect it. Well, of course, it had all sorts of problems. So we drilled through the barrel and have the M1 Garand that we know and love today. Those are rare. Most of the gas traps were, of course, modified to the standard configuration. So surviving examples are pretty far and few between. Coming over here, look at some of these beautiful Colts. A lot of those, again, are courtesy of the Dr. Robert Azar collection, the same collection where you see the world-class Colts in our premier auctions. Here are some of his Colts in our Sporting Collector auction. This is a fantastic opportunity. Look at the serial number on that. No, ERRS 36. Beautiful Navy version. There's just beautiful Colts. Hard to pull away from those. But let's get to one of the stars of the show, one that's been getting its fair share of press. Of course, a single action Army, as owned by John Wayne and used by John Wayne, as seen in True Grit, as that photo right there would indicate. It was used in True Grit, Rooster Cogburn, The Cowboys, I think a couple others as well. We have more information on the site, but it's documented by serial number. It comes with quite a bit of documented provenance and affidavits. And there are the shaped grips that he liked to use. It's a treat. A John Wayne used Colt. Let you get some tongues wagging. Here's one that we've done a video on, a Gene Autry Colt. So if you haven't seen that video, hey, go check that one out afterwards too. Gene Autry and John Wayne, cases right next to each other. Little gambler kit, little engraved, looks like Hopkins and Allen. Sitting right there at the bottom. You never know what you'll find. I see. I see you don't know what you're finding. You know, plenty of bayonets, plenty of military surplus. I see like pole arms and pole axes out of the back there, and some display cases with knives and more military arms than you can shake a stick at. Trust me. Guys, when I say this is the best gun show you've never been to, I do mean it. I don't take that lightly. I've been to my fair share. Some inert guns, unfortunately. Oh man, that Soviet PM1910. Still, what a cool display piece, but boy, you wish something like that was functional. Oh man. We got a DeWitt Lewis right behind her. Look at this monster. That'll be a German model 1934. It's a stereoscopic artillery rangefinder with, of course, its tripod. Look great in the living room. Some big old percussion punt guns. Here is one again from Mahler collection, along with those 1901s. Here's a 1903. It's not just any 1903, in case you couldn't tell. This, let's just, you know what, let's just move it over. Look at that. U.S. Springfield Armory, serial number 50, that is 50. Best of all, something that early, it should be chambered in 30-03. This one is. It did not get converted to 30-06 like so many others. And it did not get the 1905 conversion to a standard bayonet. We still see the rod bayonet on here. So, boy, lot to write home about on this. Not only, I mean, just an early serial number of an absolutely quintessential American firearm, but from the Mahler collection, you know it's going to be good. Let's take a look inside Pat's place. Now, we have been showing off pieces from the John Fox collection in here. Well, not with 400 pieces from George Mahler's collection. We're going to show those off. Instead, we got Colt revolving rifles. I see beautiful flintlocks. I see some Sniper Garands, Johnsons, Remington rolling blocks. Oh, here's some pretty interesting line throwers. Naval Company
bridge line throwing. No surprise that this is a shoulder arm and is in the George Mahler collection. It is comprehensive. I don't know how many times I can say that and before it really becomes crystal clear how comprehensive this collection was. A speed loader for repeaters, for Spencer specifically. Well, as close as a speed loader as you get in Civil War time. Liberators right next to Luger carbines. Let me get that out of the way. It's a little bit of everything, and when we say that, we put it next to night vision scopes, to all the way to Desert Storm, all the way to percussion locks, trapdoor breech blocks on display. Again, this was a very comprehensive collection. Oh, but let's not leave out the other side of the room, especially when you can find trapdoors with a... is that the Maynard device? No, Maynard primer. Metcalf device, there we go, the Metcalf device with the for the ammunition on the side. Anything they could do to help speed up loading during combat, they were all about. It's beautiful. Garand's back here. There's our little Patterson. There's our little revolving rifle there. And you can pick it up and you can touch it. That's right next to a Grapevine, right next to a Sharps, and you can come and inspect it all. And if you haven't seen our video course on the old M2-2 flamethrower, we recommend you check that out. Let's mosey out of Pat's place. See what we can walk through and find on day three. Lots of sporting arms. I know we've showed a lot of military surplus, but no shortage of sporting arms. Whether you're looking for just 22 plinkings, whether you're looking for deer rifles, whether you're looking for shotguns, and of course, we've got it all. No shortage of affordable military surplus as well, with the SKS, with the Mosins, you name it. Where else are you gonna find them? Oh, those are cool. If you've got the gun, you need the box. I mentioned in another video just recently, guns will come and go. Always buy the accessories. Some accessories will come by once in a lifetime, and you'll wish you had them after you have the gun. But the guns will come and go. You'll see more examples of guns, at least most guns. Obviously, there's exceptions, but buy the accessories, people. That's not coming from me. That's coming from a collector who is around longer and much wiser than myself. Inert display. That is an inert display, but MG42. Take a look inside. Just one of these pistol cases. Why not, right? So those Colt pockets, the little Browning 25s, 1903 pocket hammerless. Little Webleys in the back. And it just, I mean, if that's how full one is, those cases go down there and they go across over here. Gives you an idea. The scale of the auction. Do you have rules for how your viewers can pick up or handle merchandise? Nope, at this point, we just have gloves we request people wear. Boy, look at that. We have gloves that we request you wear. We provide those. They're just the, they're not the latex gloves. They're the black nitrile gloves. So you can pick up, you can touch and inspect it, and generally we'll, you know, stand next to you while you're doing it, and when you're done, we'll put it away for you and relock it up, and you have a pretty good time. But yeah, you have to be able to inspect this stuff if you're going to spend good money on it. If you want to know what you're adding into your collection, you got to know. Now, for those that can't come and you still have questions on an item, please, please send those to us. That's info@rockislandauction.com. We're happy to take additional photos. We're happy to answer questions on items or inspect them or... you know, verify caliber, things of that nature. One last cool piece, gang. I'm gonna come down here. How's this for a curio? Not only is it a wheel lock, so a wheel lock in and of itself is almost a curio, but a wheel lock that's shaped like a giant key.
How fun is that? There's a conversation piece for a collection. Sorry about the glare. There we go. See if we can get there. What an interesting item.
Whoa, that was a little closer than I thought. There we go. Hey everybody, I hope you enjoyed walking around and looking at 7,000 guns with me this morning. There's so much to do. It is the best gun show that you haven't been to yet. And why not? You like gun shows, right? We don't have any jerky like regular gun shows, but we also don't have people crackling off stun guns and $5 knives. So it's all guns. There's bronzes, there's bayonets, there's things that gun guys like at Rock Island Auction Company. So come see us. Again, we're open all day today, open to the public, and the auction is October 6th, 7th, and 8th. If you can't make it, you can check it all out on rockislandauction.com. You can place bids there, you can look at additional photos, et cetera, et cetera. Oh man, I should have a stun gun guy just for the effect. Just so people feel at home, just so people feel more comfortable with, 7,000 guns. It might be a bit overwhelming. You might need that comfort. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Till next time. Get to Rock Island Auction Company, why don't you? Come see this in person and keep your powder dry.